This is Hans De Wit. It's a great pleasure for me to attend this virtual Web CIDR for BI in absence of the conference and my keynote, which I was supposed to give in Brazil this week. It's really a sad situation for everybody around the world with this COVID-19 crisis. And not to be able to communicate in person. But at the same time, we have to appreciate the opportunities that technology brings to be communicating at distance this forum. I have been asked to address some key questions, first of all about what are the implications of the COVID-19 crisis for higher education around the world and for its internationalization, and how does that relate also to the Latin American context and to the theme of the 4BI conference, Global Learning for All. I think there's a strong connection between those three themes. First of all, it's very clear that currently higher education in the world is, like everything else, very much affected by the COVID-19 crisis. We will see that our campuses are closed. We see that students overall have difficulties to communicate with their professors, that there is uncertainty about what is happening in the near future and the long-term future with teaching and learning and higher education. And so we have to challenge ourselves, what are the risks that we take with this ongoing crisis, but also how can we try to create opportunities coming out of this crisis? And that implies also to internationalization, because internationalization has been a very important part of this crisis, because all our international connections are disrupted by the crisis, and this implies that we don't have possibilities for international students to go to study abroad. We don't have credit mobility where students take a semester or a short period or a year abroad. We see that many international students are stranded and face challenges by what is their future? Can they go back home? Can they come back to their host country? Can they continue in study, or do they have to go on online teaching and learning? All those questions are certainly at the center of this crisis. And we are faced with the fact, well, what does it mean for us? We don't know much of it because it's still unclear what the long-term implications are, even what the midterm indications are. We don't know what is going to happen in the next semester of the academic year. Are we going to open our campuses, or are we also continuing with digital education? What does that mean for students who had already planned to go abroad? What does it mean for international students who are stranded or in their host country or in their home country? Will they continue to study in the next semester? What does it mean for new entering international students? Will they have the opportunity to go to study in another country, or will they decide to go digital, or will they decide to stay at home? All those questions are still in the air and we don't have concrete answers. That also implies to Latin America. We don't know what the implications are. We don't know if study abroad, which is an important part, but not such an important part as in other countries and regions of the world, of internationalization of higher education, of students will have the opportunity to go to other continents or even to be mobile in their own countries. What will happen with the international students who are from Peru and Ecuador, etc., to go to study in other countries like Chile and Argentina and Brazil? What will happen with all those pure refugee students from Venezuela? Will they have possibilities to go? We don't know what that means. We don't know if universities will be prepared for the future. We also have a very unstable political situation in many countries, and we don't know what the impact of that will mean. Will they support higher education in the future? Or will they go on the other way and say, we don't give priority because we have other problems that are more important than higher education. What will it mean for the strong private sector of higher education in Latin America, which is already over 50% of the higher education provision? Will that be affected by the crisis? Will they get into danger? Will there be a lot of closures of private higher education institutions? How will the public sector survive with an increasing massification when all those students who now go to private higher education want to enter into public higher education, which is cheaper for them and still gives them the opportunity to study? Will governments give enough support for that? The same applies for internationalization of higher education in Latin America. Will it be an opportunity or a risk? As we know from all kinds of studies, internationalization of higher education in Latin America has been a very elitist dimension because only those who could afford it could be going abroad for their full degree or as part of their home degree to study abroad. We had far less international students in Latin America than in other countries, and if there were international students, they were mainly from the region and not from outside. And the study abroad programs from Europe and the United States already were very fragile by the economic and political context in which they had to operate. So in that sense, the implications of internationalization in the sense of study abroad and international student mobility will be far less in Latin America than it is, for instance, in Australia, the UK, United States, Canada, etc., which are already affected by insecurity about their possibilities to recruit international students, and will for sure in the coming years see a rapid decrease of students that are going to study there. The impact might be less in Asia. Asia might even be the alternative market, which is already was emerging as and will become a leading provision of international students compared to the developed world in Europe and North America in the past in Australia. We will see. But in that sense, I think Latin America has, of course, many risks with respect to the quality and the funding of higher education and the access to higher education, but also might have an opportunity here. We have already seen over the years that increasingly internationalization at home has become a driving agenda point for higher education institutions in the internationalization strategy, because many Latin American institutions of higher education were aware that for them, the possibilities to recruit international students in large numbers as a revenue source or as an international classroom source were limited. That also the study abroad opportunities for students as part of their home degree were very limited to a small elite of students. We also saw that in many cases, internationalization was still rather fragmented and marginal in Latin American higher education institutions. So what does that mean? In my view, it creates new opportunities for Latin American higher education to focus even more on internationalization at home, internationalization of the curriculum, collaborative online international learning as a way to provide students with the opportunity to understand what is happening in the world. So global learning for all students is now the moment to start to work on by developing strategies in which you are indeed internationalizing the curriculum, in which you train your faculty to prepare for that, in which you prepare your students to be much more intercultural and internationally competent, that we are looking into ways how universities in Latin America work together in their joint research. Because research has been, and science in general, now much more to the forefront than it was in the past decades, where there was an anti-international research collaboration atmosphere, where there was anti-international and general atmosphere. Now we see that research is essential to survive us from this crisis. So there are opportunities there and we have to take them. And Latin America might be better prepared because it's not affected so much by the mobility focus in internationalization of higher education, so it can much more better concentrate on internationalization at home. In that sense, also, as Marcelo Noble, director of UNICAMP, in a recent webinar for the International American Inter-American Organization for Higher Education, OIE, said, we might use this moment where we have to digitalize to address the opportunities for students who have no access to higher education because they are not located in cities where there are universities, that they have to work. And so they can use digitalization as an opportunity also to have access to higher education if we shift our focus from physical education to digital education more as a hybrid model. This is one way how to look at it in the local context. But also, as he and I said in that webinar, there are opportunities now to bring in expertise internationally by using the online opportunities, by bringing in faculty from abroad who are experts in fields that are not complementary to the local expertise of the faculty. We have not done that so much in the past, and now by working much more on a digitalized higher education, we can take that opportunity. It's only possible when there is leadership. Leadership to do that. Because leadership requires that we invest in good internet connections, that we invest in training our faculty to be much more equipped for online learning, that we invest in collaborative online learning opportunities with partners abroad, that we provide our students with the technology and the environment to do more digitally. That is an opportunity. We should not completely in that move from physical to digital learning. We know that intercultural communication in a physical way is important. So students have to meet with professors, students have to meet together. And we have to continue to do that, but we can use more the digital aspect as part of that process. And so what we have to do, in my view, in this process of post-corona transition is to prepare ourselves for a different way how we deliver higher education by making it much more hybrid, by making much more use of the possibilities of digitalization for both delivering of education in the local context, but also for delivering education in the international context, by mixing physical context with digital context and by making opportunities for students and faculty to be in touch around the world without necessarily have to move. Of course, if they can move, we should move more as well, but we can do that much more in the local context. So for Latin America, it's also an opportunity to regionalize, to be much more connected within the region, not only looking at North America, Europe, Australia, and more recently China. Look at how you can collaborate in research and teaching in the region itself, because you have a solid quality basis higher education that creates this opportunity for regionalization and for internationalization and making possibilities to have global learning for all by having a strategy for internationalization that connects with that regional and international context, both physically and digitally. I wish you all a safe and secure environment in Brazil and everywhere else where you are in Latin America or even globally, and hope that we don't are only critical about the current situation, but also see there as opportunities how we can make internationalization and higher education better for the future. Thank you very much.